Hey folks, and welcome back to the second day of my Wild 8 survival playthrough. I'm playing still single player mode, because sadly, Travis and Steve do not have the game, so I'm not going to be doing multiplayer anytime soon until they decide to maybe pick it up. I guess they'll look at these videos and see how they like it, but until then, we're going to be doing single player, and I'm going to be using Chang as my survivor, because he has plus 10% to his skill increase. And if you haven't watched the previous part of this, the day zero, I just went over the basics of mechanics in the game to show you guys how it's played. And now I'm going to start fresh, brand new, and get into the game and try to collect resources and explore the map and get as far as I can before most likely a wolf's going to kill me. That's typically how my games end that I've played so far, so you can look forward to that. Okay, and one thing before we start, because this is something brand new that I haven't seen before, it must have come through in an update just recently, the developers have created two different modes. Classic, which is the way the developers intended the game to be played, and easy mode, that the effects of cold are reduced, the effects of hunger are reduced, learning the skills and levels are retained when you die. So that's tempting, but I'm still going to go with the classic mode because that is the way it was intended to be played, and I figured I'd stick with that because that's how I've been playing so far. As I mentioned before, I am going to be playing Chang, and I'll quickly read off his benefits. Chang is the most intelligent of the survivors, and he gets minus 10% to the cost of learning new skills, which I think overall is going to be very, very important, especially if I get very, very far and decide I want to sort of start again after I inevitably die. Okay, I'm going to actually skip the tutorial because we sort of went over that last time. I'm going to go ahead and this is different. Okay, this is... Alrighty, this is actually quite different. I guess they either changed the start completely, or they've just simply added it so the start isn't going to look exactly the same each time, and it doesn't because this was definitely not how things looked right at the beginning. It kind of threw me off. Ooh, you got a med kit too. Let me just roll over there. Med kit, so that is something which you did not start off with before, or which I didn't start off with before. So I'm actually kind of happy about this. It's kind of neat to start fresh and get something completely different than what I've been experiencing in the past. So what we're going to do is build the shelter, which is the first thing most people do in the game. And then I'm going to start gathering resources, including gathering up as many mushrooms as possible, because I want to stockpile as much food. What the hell? That guy's moving quick. Holy hell, that was moving really quickly. Okay, anyways, so I'm going to gather mushrooms, I'm going to start gathering wood, and then I'm going to start gathering the ore. I may skip this part. I'm not even coming close to hitting the tree. There we go. I may skip this part, or at least the gathering process, just because it's basically going to be the same as you've seen in the past, and I like to gather up a fair amount of both wood and ore before I start going. I like to upgrade both my tent, build the workshop, upgrade that as well too, and then create a stockpile of chests that are filled with the same components. So yeah, let's just cut to, I guess, when I have a whole bunch of resources and I've upgraded some stuff. However, if anything exciting happens, I'll still be recording, so you guys will get to see that as well too. I want to get a quieter mouse, because I noticed this mouse, I don't really notice it while I'm playing games typically, but when I'm editing the sound part of it, if there's quiet moments, you can hear the mouse clicking, which is really, really strange. I didn't notice it was that loud until it started getting picked up by the microphone. Either that or I was going to change the settings on the microphone. I'd like to hold off on eating canned goods as long as possible. Same thing with the energy bar, because they fill up your hunger bar a lot. So if I can, I'd like to save those for when I really, really need a boost of food. Oh, this is nice too. They did not have this last time I played. There's a status bar over top of the fire so you can see when it's about to burn out. That is really, really useful. So they are updating this game. It's like I mentioned before in the previous part, they are in early access still. And it's little changes like this which I think are important because they're very, very useful. Right now, it wasn't in the workshop. I wanted to build a chest so I could start storing some of this stuff, and I forgot that you don't need the workshop for that. You just need to place the chest. I wonder if there's more supplies that I've missed because this is a different crash site than I was used to in the past. I'm going to put 80 and 80 in there, And I'm just going to mine this as much as I can, and then I'm going to gather a bunch of wood afterwards. Okay, so I've exhausted my mining resource here, so I'm just going to start focusing on wood for a while. And then once I fill up a chest of all these supplies, I will start upgrading my stuff and exploring, which is the most fun part of the game so far, in my opinion anyway, so. Alrighty, and I've already sort of went against my, not advice, but the suggestion of what I was going to do, and I haven't been gathering a bunch of food, which I should have been in the meantime, so I'm going to quickly see if I can scrounge up some more mushrooms so that I don't have to rely on using my canned goods right away. One of the weird things is that when I watch playback of me playing and I'm like, oh, I can't find any mushrooms, I always seem to find mushrooms during the video playback part, so. In this case, I found one mushroom. I can't see any other ones, but I've probably just missed them, so. So yeah, feel free to shout out that I've missed a ton of resources as I was sort of gathering. Also, I almost forgot to eat the mushroom, which is the most important part. You cook it, and then you're supposed to eat it, so. Maybe instead of mushrooms, I should be focusing on meat. Because there was the one deer, and I can probably upgrade my workshop so that I can start doing some rabbit snares. I do have a couple mushrooms. These will sort of tie me over. Once again, I can always just, if it's absolutely necessary, I can always go and dig into my canned goods as well, too. But I do want to hold off on that as long as possible. There's another deposit of ore here, which is going to be good because I'm going to need that. Okay, to upgrade the workshop, I'm going to need 50 wood. I'm actually going to take from my stockpile here because I did get 80, and I just want to, because I want to be able to make snares as quickly as possible, because this place has been lousy with rabbits around here, so I really want to upgrade and be able to start making some snares. So I'm going to create 3 of those, and then hopefully I can drive these rabbits to the snares and I can get some tasty, tasty meat. Because meat is really, really good when it comes to it. Now, in the past, if you walk over your snare, you end up knocking it down. And I don't want to do that. I want to be able to drive this rabbit into the snare. Into the... No, go into the snare. Nope. I should just be hitting him at this point. Come on. Stop it. Stop. Where are you going? You're going everywhere except where I want you to go. No, no. Turn around. Turn around. There we go. Okay, let's try to herd you back into the trap. There you are. Okay. There you go. Yeah, that's the direction. Keep going. Keep going. Did... What? Right... You damn rabbit. Where did he go? How far did he go? Oh, he's right there. He's hiding in the shadows. Okay. So let's drive him through here again. Into the snare. No! He does not want that snare. How do you know that that's a snare? I can't find him now. Oh, there he is. Yes. 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 Okay. So that's not how I planned to hunt the rabbit. He did drop something else. Right. There we go. Okay. But still, you know, sometimes the best laid plans don't work out. I do have a snare set up there, so should a rabbit wander by again, I don't think another one will. I wonder if you can pick them up now. It'd be nice if you could pick up snares after you've created them, but I don't think you can. Okay. Now there's another rabbit. I'm actually going to try to do the same thing I did before and try to force this rabbit into going into my trap. Okay, he's heading there. He's heading there. He's heading there. Come on. Oh, you're so close to it. You son of a bitching rabbit. Come on. Go. No, don't. No, not that way. I should just be hitting him. Have they just made it so that it's, you can actually hit rabbits easier than you can snare them? Like, is that sort of the change that they've made here? Because I used to be able to drive rabbits into these snares a lot easier in the past. Okay, no, no, no. There we go. Yeah, that's... What? Oh, there he goes. Okay, I was like, did they actually make it so that rabbits can tunnel underground now? But I guess that was just sort of like a clipping issue. Yes, 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 no, no, into the snare. No, into the... God damn you. Okay, this is ridiculous. This is beyond ridiculous. Okay, I'm going to eat more rabbit meat. Do some berries now. I'm going to give up on getting that rabbit, though there is another rabbit close, at least I know, so I can try to get that into the snare. Build the fire again. I'm going to build another chest. I typically build two chests. The reason why, I wonder if I could create a series of chests and then funnel a rabbit into my traps. That might be something that I'll explore later on. I like creating two chests. I like having one with the ore and the wood that I collect, and one that I just put items that I don't necessarily need to have on me right away. Once again, I'm going to try to consume the food that I find from the land as opposed to the canned goods and stuff, which I don't find very often. So I'm going to put those away for now. I'm going to keep snares because I find snares are useful. I shouldn't run into anything that requires me to use a med kit anytime soon, so I'm going to put that away as well too, and I'm going to continue to, once again, gather up more wood. Okay, there's a blizzard. So let's run back to the tent, because otherwise I'm just going to get way too cold way too quickly. And I should have the resources to sleep, right? Yes, I do have 20 wood and 5 ore, so I'm going to sleep for a couple minutes and wait out this annoying blizzard. Now, one of the great things about sleeping in the game, it takes 2 minutes of real time. That part's not great. But it doesn't just protect you from blizzards. It also puts a halt to you getting hungry and you needing heat. So it's sort of a bonus on top of being able to protect you from the unusual elements like a blizzard, and just generally protects you from the things that you're constantly fighting, which is hunger and cold in this game. Okay, I'm going to chance waking up, even though it's kind of a waste of resources, but I want to continue moving on. Now, I have gained skills, so I'm going to actually use my skill tree so that I can start getting bone from animals, from hunting. And sprint, can I upgrade this yet? I need 20 ore, so I'm going to then upgrade my backpack. And before I do anything else, I'm going to grab some of my ore that I've stockpiled, and I'm going to upgrade my shelter. So to unlock the level 2 skills, I do not have enough skill to get tendon extraction yet, which is unfortunate, and then I'm just going to increase my speed. I'm not going to use Axe Mastery. I'm just going to put my gathering points right now into my backpack. Now, I do need to start with fire again. So again, I can't see if there's any berries or anything around here. I don't see any berries. Just a bunch of trees and stuff. So I may have to dip into my canned goods. Unless I can kill this rabbit. I might be able to, actually, do what I wasn't able to do before, which is drive it into this trap. So let's see if I can drive it into this trap. Maybe it's because I put the trap too close to the camp and it wasn't having it, but... No. Or just... Is it just noticing the traps now? Anyways, I have to get haul ass and get back to camp. Because I'm going to be starving very soon. So let's grab the canned goods and dip into the canned goods, sadly. I'm going to have to do that. Start the fire again. Warm up. As you can see, canned goods are very, very good for filling up your hunger bar, but I didn't want to have to dip into them right away. Hoping to be able to get more stuff from gathering. Not just because it makes it so that I don't have to dip into these resources, but you also gain experience for gathering and hunting and stuff. So I'd rather gain experience. See, here's berries here at least, so that's good. So that will tie me over for a while. More berries, more mushrooms. I don't want to go too far in any direction right off the bat because you do run into wolves, and I am not equipped at this point to deal with wolf attacks. So I just got to turn to see the mushrooms. There we go. All right, so I'm gaining more food. I'm already cold. Okay, more berries. Let's start gathering up some herbs as well, too. I could hunt the deer. I think maybe I should just start going after the deer. These rabbits, though surprisingly I was able to kill one with an axe, which is something I was hardly able to do before. But let's try this one. Let's try to get this rabbit. I do need to warm up soon, though. Now, the rabbit was over here. He's over there. So I'm going to gather resources as I'm going. Still cold, though. No? Yes! They do. They purposely avoid the traps. Do you need to bait the traps now or something, maybe? But they will avoid the traps. They never used to do that. You used to be able to drive them into the traps. So I'm not sure why all of a sudden I'm not able to do that, but I do need to gain some heat, though. Okay, I'm not fully warmed up. We do have a deer that was clipping right through the snow. I didn't notice much in the way of clipping issues before, so this is kind of new. I did get 1 point to offense, so I may actually go ahead and... Yeah, I'm going to upgrade that now, because that's going to help with hunting. Also, unlocks attack speed, which is useful. Do I have any other points in anything else? No, I do not, so... Though I just got one in mobility. So, yeah. Smack that ass. There we go. I did see a herb up here, so I'm just going to grab that while I'm hunting. Now, where did that deer go? Wow, that was surprising. I got both that rabbit and the deer. I can't usually, like, get close enough to rabbits to kill them that way. Oh, great. So it is a blizzard, which means I'm going to start getting cold really, really quick. So I'm going to just build a fire here. This is a huge waste of wood, because you're fighting the blizzard and your fire goes down super quick, as you can see, during a blizzard, which sucks. So you have to constantly keep feeding your fire, gathering resources, and just trying to stay warm until the blizzard passes. It's much easier to stay out of a blizzard, or stay into your shelter to get through a blizzard, but I don't have that option right now because I've kind of shot myself in the foot here. I've also run out of my axe, so I'm not going to be able to gather wood as quickly. Okay, that worked out a little bit better. I have lost my axe. I do still have a pickaxe, so maybe I'll be able to continue to hunt that deer. Now, I don't know if this is the deer or not. We'll find out when we hit it, and if it's... Okay, it is. So, luckily, that is the same deer. So I don't have to, like, start over fresh with a new deer. Wow, stop moving, please. Just stop. 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 Where... Okay. There we go. So... The pickaxe doesn't do bad damage. I should actually check to see if it does the same amount of damage as an axe. But I should be one more hit away from it, which is good, because I'm actually running out. Okay, good. So I want to make sure that I gather up all the resources that this thing dropped. Wow, did you really only give me one drumstick? Oh no, there's two. Okay, so there was two right there. I swear it looked like there was only one, but maybe they've changed it, so... how far am I... Look how far I've gone! So I'm going to head back to my camp. If I can make it to the camp, that's great. If not, I'll just go to the fire that I've already built here. Yeah, I'm just probably going to go to the fire. I did see a mushroom back there, so I got to remember that and pick that up. Now, let's see on the map. Does the map show where the traps are? No. Maps don't show where I place traps, which is unfortunate. The good thing about deer meat is it fills up so much of your hunger, which is really, really great. It also seems to make you warm. I didn't notice that before. It seems to make you warm as well, too. So that's a useful benefit. On top of that, berries. There was more mushrooms back here. I'm sure I saw some mushrooms back here. There we go. There's mushrooms, and then I saw some herbs. Herbs are useful, especially later on when you're going to be fighting wolves, and you need to make... some healing salve, so let's see if there's... Is that... I think that's herbs there, right? Yeah, that's herbs. More herbs. Came back just in the right time. I do not have the required wood, but I do have wood in here. No, I don't. So let's start this fire. And let's gather... See if I can gather the wood quickly enough. Even though I'm using the wrong tool. So let's not waste the tool. I will waste the tool, fine. If I get to 20, I can go and sleep. Okay, so I got 20, and yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and sleep. Okay, the blizzard is gone, so I'm actually going to try something. First, I'm going to put more points into these skills here. And I think that's it, yes. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a rabbit's foot. I have killed a rabbit, so I do have one rabbit meat. That's all I need to create a rabbit's foot. Now, it's a tool that increases your character's luck, so maybe this will help me with catching the rabbits. I'm also going to go ahead and just create 5 of the healing salves. Is it salve or salve? I'm not sure if that's like a potato potato thing or if there is one definite way that you are supposed to pronounce it. So the rabbit's foot I will put into my inventory. So you can put it, yeah, in this little toolbar here. So not exactly sure what luck does for the most part, but if it does help me catch rabbits, that would be great. And the rest of the meat I'm just going to cook up and eat. Okay, now I realize I said I was going to gain resources, but screw this. I'm going to try to get this rabbit into this trap once again. Come on, come on. Like, it would rather go near me enough to hit my axe than go near that snare, which is stupid beyond... I mean, it makes hunting them easier in that sense. All I have to do is get a rabbit near a snare, and then it just acts like a fool. But yeah. Like, it'll run right through the camp, but it will not... It will just avoid that trap. Pain in the butt. You are just killing me, rabbit. Okay, now, as you can see, I have been spending my time gathering up these resources. Unfortunately, I did that at the expense of gathering food, so I did have to dip into my canned food resources here. And I'm going to continue... Oh, don't step... You know what? Screw it, because I have been having very bad luck. I'm just going to step on it and see if it... Yeah, okay, so it breaks it if you step on it. So that hasn't changed, unfortunately. But as well, too, when I mention these changes that they've made, I'm not at this point saying whether they're changes for the worse or even necessarily changes for the better. It's just that they're changes they've made to the game because this is a early access game and changes like that are inevitable. So I think, like, if you have to work a little harder to get rabbits into the snares, that's not the end of the world. That actually makes sort of a bit of sense as opposed to herding them like they were sheep into a trap. But if the rabbits are going to completely avoid the snares, that's something that is really sort of counterproductive when it comes to the hunting rabbits anyways in this game. Blizzards seem to happen. I don't know if they're just random, completely random, or if there's sort of a set number of blizzards you're expected to get within a set period of time. But if that's the case, I do notice in this playthrough that blizzards are happening a bit more frequently than I've noticed them happening in the past. I don't know whether that's real or whether it's just something I am just imagining in my head, but they do seem to be popping up a bit more often. Okay, I'm gonna dip into my stockpile and start upgrading my workshop. Yes, so I can upgrade workshop 2. And I need skin to upgrade it again, so that's something I'm gonna have to work on. And I'm going to upgrade the shelter as well. Now, one thing to note with your shelter is that when you upgrade it, you gain backpack spaces, which is really great, because this way you can carry some of these resources. You can't carry chests with you, but you can carry your shelter with you. So what I like to do is make sure that I have an 80 of ore and an 80 of wood in my tent at all time, once it's upgraded, you know, to the second level. So now, was there berries here? Berries. Okay, excellent. So that'll keep me for a little bit while I continue to explore. Once again, I'll show the map. I don't want to go too far in any direction around the initial spawn point, because once you get to about 4 or 5 out, you can start to encounter wolves. And wolves are something I can't deal with right now with my current weapon and without carrying any of my healing salves with me. So maybe I should just start hunting. It is getting later, so I should probably get back to my camp. How far am I? I'm not too far. Now, this goes up and around, so... Okay, I was able to track down this deer, hoping it would drop something other than... No, it just dropped. I really need them to start dropping some bone and stuff so I can make some better weapons. I am very close to dying because of cold. So let's go ahead and build a campfire here, even though I'm super close to base camp. Because I don't want to die from exposure. And I will cook some meat. These are the weird little close calls that I find myself getting into all the time, because I get so focused on, like, trying to kill this deer or trying to capture this rabbit or something like that, that I don't pay attention to my heat and hunger bar. And it sort of sneaks up on me that I'm actually dying and don't know it. Okay, now, as you can see, I have done more gathering. I've gained a bunch of wood, a bunch of ore. I have 3 stacks of each there. I have 1 stack of each in my shelter. I also have a bunch of extra healing salve, or salve. I really don't know which way to, how to say that. Healing salve, 8 here. I've got meat cooked. I've got a bunch of northern berries. I have an energy bar, which I can keep there. I also have a med kit in the chest here. I made myself some throwing rocks, a extra stone axe, and an extra stone pickaxe. And I have dual axes in my on and off hand. I'm going to go ahead now and make some wooden armor and make some wooden shoes. Now, these look ridiculous, as you can see. It's basically like duct tape and sticks, and that's his wooden armor, and the same thing goes for the shoes. I don't know how that's really going to help someone, but it is what it is. I'm going to take one of my wood stacks from here, and now what I'm going to do is I am going to go and try to find the rest of Flight 816 and see if there's anything in the ruins. And I'm going to risk wolves to do it. It's actually 2 a.m., so I may... You know what? I'm going to wait until morning when it's not going to be super cold to travel there. I'm going to eat some food very, very quickly. And I will be right back when morning breaks. Okay, it is just about morning. I have full health, almost full hunger, almost full cold. Before I head out to find the crash site, I am going to spend my last skill points here. I get another one. Do I want it in speed or do I want... I want it in damage right now. And I'm going to upgrade my backpack one more time. Now, we've got 70 ore and 47 wood, so I may take a couple swipes at trees on my way to the crash site. But for the most part, I think we're geared up so that we can even survive a single wolf attack. Now, there are two types of wolves in this game that I've discovered so far. There are the normal wolves, and those are... assholes for the most part, and they are tougher than I am and they're stronger than I am, but with the right weapons I can even the odds. I don't have the right weapons yet, but I do have an axe, which is sort of good against fighting them. I also made some throwing rocks, because even though throwing rocks aren't great, I'm going to gather supplies as I go, even though rocks I don't find are great when hunting game animals, I'm hoping that they're decent when going after wolves. Apparently I did find the crash site. Where is it? Look for something useful near the tail of the airplane. Well, where is it? Or did I not? Oh, there it is. Okay, so I hadn't quite hit it. Once you there's like these invisible borders, and once you cross them, entire squares get opened up. So sometimes they warn you of stuff like 2 steps before you actually find it. So we've got the generator here. We got another bit of canned food, which is great. Now, there's also a mushroom. I will pick that up. Now, near here is where I can actually use the generator, if memory serves me correctly. But there are also wolves around that area at times. Oh, yeah, I didn't finish my previous thought, which was there are two types of wolves. There are the regular wolves. And yeah, like I've mentioned, they are assholes. They suck, and they tend to kill me. However, see, we found a radio tower. Even though we're not there yet, we're not right at the radio tower yet. And then there are wolves with glowing green eyes and sort of like more like silverback fur. And those things are monstrous. They're not super huge like in size, but they are such assholes. They make the other. Oh, there's a wolf right there. There's a wolf right there. Now, is it the big bad one or is it just the regular style one? It's just the regular style one. Oh, we got a rabbit in here. You know what? Let's just. There we go. That was extremely lucky to have the rabbit in here. We're out of room for it, so... Now, the wolf can't get at me in here, I don't think. Nope, can't get at me. So, I'm going to go ahead and eat... you know what? I'm going to eat the food ration to gather up this. I'm going to put the generator in here. Now, once you activate the radio station, it opens up... a wider view of the map. So there's something really cool here. I have no idea what this is. There's the radio lines here, or the power lines here, which you will be following. And there's also something just north of our shelter. Now, we do have to get past this wolf. So let's see if I can manage to get past this wolf, knowing that I do have healing. I'm going to see if I can run past, so I don't even have to deal with it. Yes, I'm taking the coward's way out. Because I got... Oh, no, it's right there. It's right there. Okay, fine. So I'm going to fight it. As you can see, I'm going down in health quicker. But I do have healing salve. So I'm going to be able to sort of even the odds that way. And I can keep hitting. No. Keep hitting him. And then the punk ass bitch runs away when he's. Oh. Now, he will come back at me. And I am gonna kill him. I'm not letting this. I'm gonna eat. So that's gonna give me a bit of extra life. He's gonna come at me one more time. Come at me. Come on. Don't you dare run away. Come on. Oh, you son of a bitch. No, I got him. I got him. Come on. I'm gonna die of heat. I gotta build a fire. I'm not letting this wolf get away. This wolf is not getting away. Come on. Come on, you son of a bitch. Oh, you jackass. If he's regaining his health, I'm screwed. One of the things previously is that wolves would always sort of come around at you again. Even if they were really low health, they would, you know, decide to come at you one more time. And there's a blizzard. How far away am I from base camp? Okay, it's straight to the west. Gain. See, he wants to come at me. He wants to keep coming at me. And I want him actually to come at me because it's going to be a lot easier for me to come after him. Oh, I can try the throwing rock. You know what? I'm going to equip the throwing rock. Don't let the fire go out. Can't believe I got to survive this blizzard first. All this just to kill this one wolf. Oh, he better drop something good as well, too. I also had a waste of ration. I needed to waste a ration because I needed to open up, oops. There we go. So, it's a good thing. This is also why I have extra axes, because if I didn't have extra axes, I, wouldn't really be able to face off against this wolf. Now, he's up here somewhere. He better stay where he is. Okay, so the blizzard's done. I'm fully warm. Where is he? There he is. There he is, right there. There, okay, good. So he's dead. Okay, so now, did he drop anything else? He didn't drop any bone or anything? What am I dying from? Oh god, that I never received a bleeding effect before. I think that was some sort of bleeding effect. I'd never received one before. I'm very, very surprised I didn't end up dying there. Okay, so we killed the wolf. Sadly, we didn't get any, like, bone from him, but we did get more meat, so we're good for meat. We've also explored the area, the crash site, which is part of the sort of the quest, one of the early quests, and we opened up all this, so we know there's stuff here, but there will be wolves there. We know there's something just two squares north, which I had no idea, so there should be some nice supplies to find there, and then we have the power lines, which we can follow to continue out, to continue with our quest. I wish when I was fighting the wolf, I wish I had remembered about the throwing rocks. I should have been using the throwing rocks. Because the throwing rocks, you equip and you hit... Is it right click? Yeah, so that probably would have been the best thing to do when I was facing off against the wolf, but oh well. Okay, so we survived the encounter with the wolf, which is better than I've done in the past. Usually I would wait until I have better weapons. I didn't want to wait that long, and I hadn't been getting any of the right drops. I'm going to quickly upgrade my skills. Yeah, see... I do have it so that the animals are supposed to be able to drop bone and tendons, but they haven't been. I'm going to click on leather because I did gain a point in that. I'm going to increase my sprint time. I'm going to continue to increase damage right now. I'm going to try to get that to full and then work on attack speed. And I've got 3 points in defense, so that went up huge. That's going to be a lot better the next time we fight off wolves. So there we go there. So now we've upgraded all the skills that we have. And I'm going to explore and find out what this is over here. However, I'm going to be doing that in the next episode. So that was the end of day one of my little survival stint in the Wild 8. Now, during day zero and during a few parts of day one, I did talk about how much I hated wolves and how they are responsible for many deaths in previous games of the Wild 8 that I've played. Luckily, I was not just able to show you what the wolves are like, but I was actually able to kill one of the wolves, so that was great. We didn't drop anything. I really need these animals to start dropping bone and tendons because you can create better weapons and, in certain cases, better tools once they drop those things. So yes, I really do hope some of these animals start dropping some of these better items. If I can get them to drop, I think just one bone, I can create a skinning knife, which will increase the chances of them dropping this as well too. All in all, not a bad start to the game. We have plenty of ore, plenty of wood, got a bunch of food, some healing products as well too. So I think we're going to be able to hit the ground running when we get to day two. In the meantime, if you guys have any questions, comments, advice, please leave that in the comment section below. If you've played The Wild 8, or if you'd like to suggest another survival game that maybe I would like, please, you can also leave that in the comment section. You can also contact and follow us on Twitter. It is at BrainPulpTV, or you can contact and follow me directly on Twitter at GeekTragedy. And now that all that is said, take care, everyone. Thank you so much for liking and subscribing. It means a lot to us here, and I will see you all very soon.